In previous tutorial, we learned about the basic of Anime.js. Now in this video, we will show you how to combine Anime.js with SVG and create more advanced animations like motion path, SVG morphing, and line drawing. Ready? Let's check it out. So one of Anime.js cool feature is you can move any element on the screen using SVG path. And here is the example page that we are going to work on. I will show you how to create a motion path and move this emoji along. First, we need to create the SVG path. You can use Photoshop, Illustrator, or any tools you like, but here's my favorite part builder on CodePen. First, I will resize the SVG to an appropriate size. Then disable snap grid options and reset the path. You can drag the existing point and use Ctrl click to add a new point. When finished, enable close path to create the loop. And that's it, you will have the path code at the bottom right. Next, I'm going to set an SVG tag and set the size to match the path we've just created. Then for path, we'll set the stroke color to red and fill to none. And paste the code from the builder. Then let's work on the animation. First, include the library using script tag. Then create motion path using path method. And pass our path element into it. Next, create animation the same way we did in previous video. We will target our emoji and use translate X and Y to move it. Now we will use the motion path we've just created as a function to get the current X and Y position. Then set the easing to linear. And the rest of the animation properties. It works, but the position is off. This is because we haven't moved the element to the starting point before we animate it. Let's create a wrapper to wrap both SVG and emoji together. Then use absolute position to set the starting position. Also, don't forget to set the wrapper position to relative to make the child element absolute position works. Motion path also support rotation. You can add it to animation like this. But for this example, I don't think it's a good idea. The next popular feature we are going to talk about is SVG Morph. It allows you to morph any SVG polygon into another. The only requirement is all shapes in the animation need to have the same number of points. Let's work on the example. First, let's create SVG tag. And then add polygon tag. I will set the stroke color to none and fill color to red. And then we are going to need points to define the shape. Let's go back to the Path Builder again. Create a new shape that you like and copy the code. The current code is in path format. To convert to point, you will need to delete M at the start and Z at the end. Then replace L with comma. And here's our shape. Now create a new shape we want to morph into from the old one. Both shapes need to have the same number of points, so you cannot add a new one. Alright, that should do it. Let's copy the code. Next, create an animation. Target the polygon element. Then we'll use points property to morph the shape. The first value object, we will use points from the first shape. And then do the same for the second shape. Then add the rest of the animation properties. To keep the animation seamless, you can also add alternate direction property. And that's all about SVG morphing. Next, let's talk about line drawing. Line drawing is a very cool feature, especially to create a text writing animation. But before we get to that, we need to understand about SVG stroke first. Here's a good example on CodePen. We already have an SVG path, and now I'm going to add a stroke-array property to it. As you can see, the stroke-array property turned the path into a dash, and if I increase the value, the dash length and the gap will be increased too. And if we keep increasing the value to some point, the length of a single dash will be long enough to represent the entire path. And now here's when stroke-offset comes to play. This property will add an offset to the dash, like this. So as you can see, if we animate the dash offset, we can create a line drawing animation. Let's go back to our example. For this tutorial, I'm going to use Photoshop to create path. First, use the text tool and type anything you like. Then select the layer, right-click, and select Create Work Path. Then at the layer menu, select Create New Fill Layer. It doesn't matter which color you choose. We only need just the path code. Finally, delete the original text layer and then export it as SVG. Click Export All and save the SVG file. Then open it with text editor and copy the path. Next, create SVG tag. Then create path. I will set the stroke color to red and stroke width to 3 and fill to none. Then paste the path code from Photoshop. The text is ready. Next, I'm going to set the stroke dash properties in the CSS file. I will set the dash array to 1000 and dash offset to 0. Next, we are going to work on the animation. First, target the path element. Then set the stroke dash offset property using library provided set dash offset value, followed by the target offset, which is 0. Then add the rest of the animation properties as usual. And that's all for this tutorial. Hope you guys enjoy. If you want to see more dev tips and tutorials, subscribe our channel to stay tuned. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.